It's an affixual language. So what that means is the way that they do grammar is they have all sorts of suffixes, which are little portions that they add on to the end of the word. Kind of like in English, we have run, running. Ing is a suffix that you tack on. In Kazakh, they can have like five suffixes tacked onto the end of the word, and so a word can get really long. And so that was really hard to get used to, and obviously I'm still not used to it. So I didn't I learned a lot more than I remember now, just because back here I literally have no opportunity to use it. But for example, my name is, you'd say, Mendingathem Elderbertus or Jacob. To ask what is your name, you say Sizdingatingizkum, and that means what is your name. I remember this one I learned really early, and it stuck with me. It's kind of funny. It just makes people laugh to say Akshajok, and you throw your hands up in the air, and that means I don't have any money, and they always laugh because that's like survival English. Anyway, I don't know why. It's an inside joke there, maybe, or something. But oh yeah, Kalin Kalai is how are you? Because it was part of the Soviet Union for so long, the people, Russian culture was integrated to the society. The Soviet Union actually sent Russians to Kazakhstan on assignment to live, so that the Russian seed was kind of spreading out. That's at least from what I understand. And so it's been, I don't know how many years. When I was serving there, it'd been maybe about 15, 16 years since the Soviet Union collapsed, and they're still struggling to assert a national identity. They don't want to be seen as a Russian province, you know what I mean, or a post-Soviet Union country. They want to be seen as Kazakhstan, an independent sovereign nation and people. And so it's interesting, when I was serving there, they j had just passed a law that all of the streets would be referred to with their Kazakh names. Because prior to that, they all had Russian names. And so I don't know if they gathered all the old maps that had the Russian street names and burnt them, or I have no idea, but when we got there, there were no maps with any of the Russian street names. Problem was, since this is such a new change, and they pretty much gave every street a new Kazakh name, the people still referred to them with the old names. And so we'd ask people for directions, ask them where they lived, and they'd tell us the Russian street names. And we'd look on the map, which only had the Kazakh names, and we'd have no idea what people were talking about. So we actually had to write in next to each street, K in Kazakh, this street is Dostik. In Russian, it's Dostoevsky. Anyway, so it was a nightmare. So I think that just shows a little bit about the culture, where even in the language, they're really trying to assert their own nationality and separate themselves from Russia and say, we're Kazakh, and this is who we are, and this is what we speak. So.